Hi students, today we can study chapter 10 vector algebra exercise 10.2. The introduction of exercise 10.2 already we have completed. At that time already we have discussed about addition of vectors, section formula, how to find out magnitude of vectors. That basic things we will use in this exercise for solving all the problems. We can do one by one. Question number one. Compute the magnitude of the following vectors. In here, three vectors given. We have to find out magnitude. First vector, A vector equal to I cap plus J cap plus K cap. In here, in this vector, two components are there. That is, scalar components and vector components. If you write any vector, from there you can write scalar components and vector components. In this vector, a nearby I, one number is there. Which number? I think means one is there. That is scalar component. Then in here also you can see one. In here also one. The scalar components of this vector is 1, 1, 1. Then, what is vector components? If you write this all things, that is, one I is vector component, then again, one j, another vector component, then one k vector. This is vector components. When you write scalar components, only numbers. When you write vector components, you have to write I cap, j cap, I cap. This is the basic of a vector. Our question, we have to find out magnitude of a vector. How to find out magnitude means, you can see. Magnitude of a vector equal to magnitude of a vector will represent modulus of a vector. Modulus of a vector means magnitude of a vector, square root of sum of squares of scalar components. In here, first scalar component is 1 square, then second scalar component again 1 square, plus third scalar component is 1 square. Square root of 1 square is 1, in here also 1, in here also 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1 equal to square root of 3. This is magnitude of given vector. Square root of sum of squares of scalar components. Like that we can find out magnitude of any vector. In here also, here the modulus of B vector equal to square root of, in here what is scalar components? 2, in here minus 7, in here minus 3, isn't it? 2 minus 7 we have to take, in here minus 3, then take square, 2 square plus minus 7 square plus minus 3 square equal to 4 plus 49 plus. What do we get? 49 plus 9, 58 plus 4, 62. Square root of 62 units. This is magnitude of B vector. So then another one, magnitude of C vector we can write. Square root of 1 by root 3 square. This is the scalar component. Then plus square root of 3. Second scalar component. Plus, in here, what is scalar components? That is, minus 1 by root. Minus 1 by root 3. 1 square is 1 divided by root 3 square. It is 3. In here also, 1 by 3. In here, minus square is plus. And from the minus plus, 1 square is 1 divided by 3. Equal to M. And same is 3. 1 plus 1 plus 1. equal to root 3 by 3 equal to 1 unit. This magnitude of C vector. In C vector, we got magnitude is 1 unit. Then, which type vector? We can say C vector is an unit vector. Why unit vector? We got magnitude is 1. Unit. Magnitude 1 means that the vector is known as unit vector. This is not unit vector, but C vector is an unit vector because of magnitude 1. Before next question, just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Question number 2. Write 2 different vectors on same magnitude. We have to write 2 different vectors with the same magnitude. Let's see. Consider one vector, A vector. And that is 1i plus 2 j vector plus 3 k vector. I consider one vector, that is a vector. We can find out magnitude. Magnitude of a vector, that is modulus of a vector. Square root of sum of squares of scalar component. Here scalar component is 1 square, in here scalar sum of 2 square, then in here 3 square. Square root of, what do you get? 1 plus 4 plus 9 equal to square root of 14 units. We got magnitude of A vector is 14 units. Then, again, we are going to write another one vector, B vector, with the same magnitude of A vector. In here magnitude is root 14 units, isn't it? Then we need magnitude same, square root of 14. Another vector, same vector we cannot write. Check it in here, scalar components, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. These are the scalar components. We can rearrange this one. Just write 2, 1, 3. We are going to write another vector with scalar components 2, 1, 3. Write 2i vector plus 1j vector plus 3k vector. I am going to use same scalar component 1, 2, 3, but always little different. In here 1i plus 2j plus 3k. In here 2i plus 1j plus 3k. Vectors are completely different. Then check it, magnitude square root of 2 square plus 1 square plus 3 square equal to square root of 4 plus 1 plus 9 equal to root 14 units. Same magnitude, same magnitude only, isn't it? How can write means just rearrange this scalar components. Okay, just shuffle that one. Therefore, A vector and B vector are vectors with same magnitude. This is our answer. Question number 3 is write 2 different vectors having same direction. We need 2 completely different vectors with the same direction. Consider one vector is P vector. P vector is equal to I vector plus J vector plus K vector. Any vector we can consider. We need same direction. How to find out direction of a vector? Look, one vector, if you write A vector is X I plus Y J plus Z. How to find out direction means we will find out direction cosines. Direction cosines. That is L equal to X divided by modulus of A vector. Then M y divided by modulus of A vector, then L equal to z divided by modulus of A vector. This is known as a direction cosine. In here x, y, z. Look, x, y, z. That is scalar components. Then modulus of A vector you can find out from here. That is modulus of A vector is square root of x square plus y square plus z square. This is modulus of A vector magnitude. Then direction cosines are equal means the direction of the two vectors are equal. From here we can find out direction cosines. Direction cosines. First L. L equal to x divided by modulus of A vector. In here x. X means coefficient of I vector. Otherwise scalar component of I vector. Then this number 1 divided by square root of we need modulus of A vector, sorry, modulus of P vector, modulus of P vector we need to say. That is 1 divided by square root of in here 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square. Because x, y, z, same. We can do 1 by root in here we get 3. L is 1 by root 3. Then M. M means scalar component of J vector. Which number in here? That also 1. 1 divided by square root of P vector. Modulus of P vector. 1 divided by here. 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square. 1 by root 3 will get. And M. M means in here takes a means there 1. 1 divided by modulus of P vector. 1 by root 3. Same. You have to same only your side of 1 by root 3. These are the direction cosines of our vector. We need one more vector with the same direction. Can consider again. Q vector is 2i vector plus 2j vector plus 2k. Take it in here 1, 1, 1. Then I will write 2, 2, 2. Just multiple with any number the scalar component. In here, 1, all the 1 I multiple with 2. Isn't it? Otherwise, you can write 3i plus 3j plus 3k. Otherwise, we can write 10i plus 10j plus 10k. In here, we are multiple with 10. In here, we are multiple with 3. This is our first vector. Then, from here, we can find out direction cosines. That is, L equal to scalar component of I is 2 divided by modulus of Q vector. 2 divided by square root of, in here, 2 square plus 2 square plus 2 square equal to 2 divided by, from here we can take, oh sorry, 4 plus 4 plus 4 equal to 2 divided by 12 equal to 2 divided by, in here 4 into 3 equal to 2 divided by 2 root 3 equal to 1 by 22 cancel. We'll get 1. Then direction cosine L we got 1 by root 3. Isn't it? Then find out M. M also using by same method 2 scalar component of J vector. 2 divided by modulus of Q vector. 2 by modulus of Q vector, modulus of Q vector, this denominator we already worry, 2 root 3, 2 root 3 equal to 1 by root 3. Then n, n is scalar component of K vector, that is 2 divided by Q vector. In here also you will get 1 by root 3. Same only, isn't it? Then second, direction cosines of P vector and Q vector. 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3. In here also 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3, 1 by root 3. Isn't it? Then direction cosines are equal means we can write P vector and Q vector are vectors with same direction. Therefore, P vector and Q vector are vectors with same direction. Just write in your notebook. Next question, question number 4. Find the value of x and y so that the vectors 2i plus 3j and xi vector plus yj vector are equal. In here, two vectors given. The two vectors are equal. We have to find out x and y. Given first vector, given vector is 2i vector plus 3j are xi vector plus yj vector are equal. These two vectors are equal. We can write 2i vector plus 3j vector equal to xi vector plus yj vector. What's equally? From here, we can write 2 equal to x. The scalar component of I is 2, left side. That is scalar component of I in right side, that is x. Then 2 and x equal. Then 3 equal to 1. 3 is scalar component of j. In here, what is scalar component of j? That is 1. This is our answer. Then question number 5. Find scalar and vector components of the vector with initial point 2, 1 and terminal point minus 5, 7. We have initial point and terminal point given. Given initial point. Initial point. Just give one name. P equal to 2, 1 and terminal point. Terminal point, that is Q minus 5, 7. Initial point and terminal point given, we have to make first one vector. Therefore, PQ vector. The one figure is P direction P to Q, because P is initial point, Q is terminal point. And then, if you consider this is x1, y1, this x2, y2. Then if you want to write PQ vector, that is x2 minus x1, I vector, plus y2 minus y1, j vector. Terminal point minus initial point, that is x2 minus x1, I vector plus y2 minus y1, j vector. Then, step 2 minus f1 also. That's why we can write in here 2 points, but if they are given 3 points, x1, y1, z1 means, we can use step 2 minus f1. Then, same method we can use in here. First, terminal point, you know, q is it? A, what is x2? That is minus 5 minus, in here, x1 is I vector plus then 7 minus 1 A vector equal to, and you get minus 7 I plus in here 6 J. We got PQ vector. What is our question? We have to find out scalar and vector components, isn't it? So we can write scalar components. Components are scalar components means hereby a unit number, that is minus 7 and here 6. Those two numbers you write minus 7 and 6. Then vector components. Vector components. You write all together minus 7 I vector and 6 j. All together you will write separately minus 7 I and 6 j vector. These vector components Before doing next problem, just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Question number 6. Find the sum of the vectors. A vector I minus 2j plus k. B vector is minus 2i plus 4j plus 5k. And C vector is I minus 6j minus 7k. We have to find out sum of these three vectors. Okay, anyway, we have a given. Which are the vectors given? A vector, that is I minus 2j plus k, then B vector equal to minus 2i plus 4j plus 5k, then C vector is I minus 6j plus minus 7k. Then sum A vector plus B vector plus C vector. Field are the scalar components of I and j and k separately. First, in here 1 plus, in here minus 2 plus, in here 1, the I vector. Only are scalar component of I vector. Then plus, next minus 2 plus 4 plus minus 6 is j. The last scalar component of k vector, in here 1 plus 5 plus minus 7 k vector. Equal to what we get? In here 1 plus 1, 2 minus 0 I vector. In here minus 4 j vector. Then last minus 1 k vector. This is our sum of those three vectors. If you are three vectors, you will get another vector only. Okay. Next question. Question number 7. Find unit vector in the direction of vector A vector equal to I plus j plus 2 k vector. In here one vector given, we have to find out unit vector of this vector. What is unit vector? A vector having magnitude is 1. If we just consider one vector, A vector is xi plus yj plus zk. So like one vector, if you want to find out unit vector represent by a cap equal to, that is x divided by modulus of A vector I plus yj divided by modulus of A vector plus zk divided by modulus of A vector. So like we can find out unit vector of a given vector. Same method we can use in here. Unit vector of A vector, that is A cap equal to, here x means 1 divided by modulus of A vector, modulus of A vector plus then j is quite high, that's not I vector, j divided by modulus of A vector plus 2k vector divided by modulus of A. Then you can find out modulus of A vector separately. Modulus of A vector is square root of 1 square plus, in here 1 square plus, in here 2 square. Square root of sum of squares of scalar components. That is modulus. Then square root of what you will get? 1, 1, 2, 4, 6. 6 you will get. 2 square is 4, then 1. A vector given here. I vector divided by modulus of A vector, that is root 6 plus j vector divided by root 6 plus 2k vector divided by root 6. This is our unit vector. We can check in here. This is the unit vector root. When you find out magnitude of this vector, we need answer 1. Check it. Magnitude of this unit vector, square root of, that is scalar component of I, that is 1 by root 6 square plus in here also 1 by root 6 square plus in here 2 by root 6 square. So equal to 1 divided by 6, in here also 1 divided by 6, in here 2 square is 4 divided by root 6 square is 6. Equal to 6, 6 LCM, then what will get? 1 plus 1 plus 6 equal to square root of 1 equal to 1. We got magnitude of this unit vector is 1. Question number 8. Find the unit vector in the direction of vector PQ vector, where P and Q are the points. P is 1, 2, 3, Q is 4, 5, 6 respectively. First we can write given points. Given points are, first point is P, is 1, 2, 3. And second point Q is 4, 5, 6. Two points given. From here we can find out PQ vector. PQ vector equal to, you know, two points given means we can find out x2 minus x1 I vector plus y2 minus y1 j vector plus z2 minus z1 k vector. In here we will consider P is initial point, Q is terminal point. Why? Look in here PQ, a direction from P to Q. That means P is initial point, Q is terminal point. So then x2 minus x1, x2 in here, this is x2, y2, z2, this is x1, y1, z1. Then x2 minus x1, 4 minus 1, I vector, then 5 minus 2, j vector, then 6 minus 3, j vector, 4 minus 1, 3 I vector plus 3 j vector, plus which are also 3 j vector. We got PQ vector. What is the question? Find the unit vector. From here we can find a unit vector. For that we can find out first modulus of PQ vector. That is square root of 3 square plus again 3 square plus 3 square. Square root of 9 plus 9 plus 9. And the root 27 units. This root 27, okay, we can write that is square root of 9 into 3. 3 root 3 units. 3 root 3 units. That means magnitude we got 3 square root of 3 units. Then unit vector. Unit. PQ equal to, again write, first write this vector 3j plus 3k vector all divided by modulus of 3i plus 3j plus 3k divided by all divided by 3. Because modulus of PQ vector, we already got it, 3 root 3. Then, if we give separately, 3i by 3 root 3, then 3j, 3 root 3, 3k, 3 root 3. Correct? 3, 3. Then, what is our answer? I by root 3 plus j by root 3 plus k by answer. I vector divided by root 3 plus j vector divided by root 3 plus k vector divided by root 3. That is our answer. Just pause the video, write down in your notebook. Now question number 9. For given vectors A vector 2i minus j plus 2k vector and B vector minus I plus j minus k vector, find the unit vector in the direction of the vector A vector plus B vector. First we will find out A vector plus B vector. Here, A vector plus B vector. That is A vector. A vector is 2i minus j plus 2k vector. Plus B vector. B vector is B vector minus I vector plus j vector minus k vector. A and B. A vector and B vector already given. This is given here. Then 2 minus, here 1 is there, isn't it? We have a 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 I vector. Then minus 1. In here minus 1. In here plus 1 j vector. Then 2 in here minus 1 j vector. Here what you will get in here 1 I. That is I vector plus in here 0 j vector. In here 2 minus 1. That is 1 k vector. This is our A vector plus B vector. That is our question. Find unit vector. We need unit vector. For that, first find out magnitude. Magnitude of A vector plus B vector. Magnitude we can represent modulus of A vector plus B vector equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. In here x means 1. 1 square plus 0 square plus in here 1 square. Equal to what you get? 1 square is 1. 1 square is 1. In here square root of 2 units. Modulus of A vector plus B vector we got square root of root 2 units. Now unit I vector divided by modulus of A vector plus B vector, that is root 2. Then 0 j vector divided by root 2 plus in here k vector divided by root 2. This is our unit vector of A vector plus B vector. We can check in here if this magnitude of this vector is 1 or not. 1 only? Then only we can say that is unit vector, isn't it? We can check it. Square root of, in here 1 by root 2 square, in here 0 by root 2 square, no need to write, then in here also 1 by root 2 square, equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 2 LCM, then 1 plus 1, 2, 1. The magnitude of this vector is 1, so this is unit vector.